So I'd say I have to commute there and back every day, as opposed to just kind of stumble back to a hotel.
Would have been nice to have a hotel to stumble back to, and a nice breakfast in bed in every morning.
Get cable? I don't have cable, so the only times I ever watch cable is when I'm in a hotel. Oh, man. All sorts of stuff going on cable.
Are we live?
Well, so the only times I ever watch cable is when I'm in a hotel.
Oh, my God, I hear my own voice.
All sorts of terrifying. Why would anyone ever watch this?
Sorry about that. Hello, everyone. Looks like we're live. And welcome to what I think we just concluded was our very first pre-release stream in the post-CP stream.
Yeah, I can't think of another time that we've gotten a game early enough, you've gotten your review out, and we've been allowed to stream a game before it was released.
There's a very thin margin between being allowed to stream it and the game coming out. It's like one day.
Yeah.
The streaming embargo was this morning.
Mm-hmm.
So this is our last chance to be really up to the minute on this shit. But yes, yesterday's review was Resident Evil 4 Remake, which we got surprisingly early. We were in the first round of reviews to be given codes, weren't we?
We were. I like emails that say you can't tell anyone you got this code.
Well, we can. I mean, what are they going to do? Call the police?
Yeah, they can't retroactively take it back. Review's already done. What are they going to do?
All right.
Thank you, Capcom, for providing early code. Please do it again with whatever next
game. Thank you, Capcom. We love you very much. I like to think they gave us this code early because they know I'm such a big fan of the original Resident Evil 4.
I imagine. I think they have, from what I've heard, all publishers have dossiers on people. So I believe in your dossier. This would probably be one of the games people know you're a big fan of.
I take it it's not a very detailed dossier.
Because it didn't have hates the idea of remakes on a blow.
Yeah, I guess they don't take their time to watch every single stream in which I brought that across.
Yeah. And before kicking us off, Loader fan, a Lord of the Rings fan 193, thank you so much for joining Tipjar, and says, I initially came to the channel for zero punctuation. I'm glad it's grown so I can look forward to something every day. Thank you so much. And Zakruel. Thank you so much for being in the tip jar for 16 months. It means a lot, Skrull. Excellent. Another post-CP for me to listen to and probably fall asleep to. I'm going to take that as a compliment.
Now, I offer a choice of viewing, as I sometimes do. We could start a brand new game and get a taste of the initial experience, which I'm sure you've all seen enough of in the demo of this game. Or I could load my New Game Plus slave and we could take shit apart with endgame weapons. What's everyone's opinion?
I mean, that sounds exciting, doesn't it? It also feels like with endgame weapons, we'll be able to progress further. We'll get more bang out of our 2-hour buck.
Yeah, probably get past where the demo ended significantly.
Yeah, I imagine, because there's probably only a little bit, and then where the demo starts, and demo's only like 20 minutes or so.
All right, then. New game plus. New game plus.
Yay.
On standard mode, because we are, after all, streaming, and I'm going to suck.
Listen, you don't need... I just finished a replay of Jedi Fallen Order, and I played it on story mode, and let me tell you, that shit was easy, and I was a big fan of it. Oh, it opens with a cutscene?
Was this not in the demo?
No. The demo starts shortly before the you enter the village. No cutscene or anything.
See, in the original, well, I guess we could start a drinking game here. Take a drink every time I bring up the
every
original.
Every time you talk about the original.
In the original, it's not clear from the beginning that it's a cult. They just stick you in a forest and away you go.
That's true. You just know that the president's daughter went missing. You don't know if it's one of those, just wandered off.
Yeah, I mean, that whole opening cinematic felt kind of needless to me. Except to spoil where the plot's going to go.
Well, and that even, what we're seeing now, is direct footage linking back to Resident Evil 2. That definitely wasn't in the original as well.
Yes, it was. The original had an opening cinematic establishing the plot of Resident Evil 2 and what Leon's been up to.
Hey, in my defense, I only replayed the original 3 weeks ago, so I have no defense.
This is giving us a little more context. We are seeing Leon getting his secret agent training.
We got a little taste of Krauser there. We don't see him.
No.
Like, he's definitely not in the opening of the original.
Well, in the original, yeah, Krauser sort of comes out of nowhere.
And you're like, who is this? Should I know this man?
Yeah, in like the midpoint of the game. Now it gets context as to how, like, rookie cop becomes badass secret agent.
Mm-hmm. Devil's Foot with a $5 dono. Thank you so much, Devil's Foot. I think there's more footage of Yahtzee playing Resident Evil 4 than any other game.
I'm not sure that is the case. Although I did.
What do you think that would be?
I don't
know.
Sea
of Thieves?
Oh, damn. I forgot I've got the silly costume equipped.
What's going on here? Why do you look like that?
There are silly costumes you unlock from the game.
Incredibly worried if they show what Ashley's gonna look like. What is she wearing?
We probably won't get that far.
I was about to say, we probably won't get all the way up to that church and into the church.
Okay, fine. We're playing with the silly costume. Oh, it's a reference to the gangster costume from the original, of course.
Oh, yeah, with the Chicago typewriter and everything.
Yes. In fact, I think the Chicago typewriter is unlockable as well.
Nice.
The sunglasses aren't part of the standard costume. The sunglasses are one of the several accessories that are available.
Accoutrement
that you can swap out.
Nice. Beastmarsh with a $5 dono. Thank you so much, Beastmarsh. Here's a dono to remove negative vibes from earlier. Appreciate it, Beastmarsh. And Katura Cowboy, thank you so much for the donation. When will the next ZP be releasing after the break? Also, is it too early to ask what it might cover?
I'm not sure, actually. We're doing a sort of ZP style or ZP like video covering GDC. Which won't be a fully zero punctuation-y episode, because it's going to have some other footage in it as well.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not sure when that's coming out. Possibly next week.
Yeah, but your next proper review probably won't be till the 12th or the 19th, probably?
Not for a while yet.
Yeah. Maybe by then more games will have come out. That'd be nice.
Yeah, it's not a bad time of year to be skipping ZPs a little bit, because there's not a whole lot coming out.
Steel-clad gamer, minimum for 10 months. Thank you so much, Steel-clad gamer. My copy of Existentially Challenged just arrived. Gonna read it. I'm gonna read the whole thing this weekend.
Oh, yes. The print version of that's out now.
Ooh.
You can get it from Amazon right now. In fact, I haven't even mentioned that anywhere. Because the Kindle and ebook versions apparently gonna take a little bit longer. So maybe I'll wait until that comes out to do the proper push.
Wolfson with $220 Canadian. Thank you so much, Wolfson. Have to ask, is the Killer 7 Magnum back? Ooh, that's a good question.
Yes, the Killer 7 is in this game.
Yes.
The Killer 7.
Are there new weapons? Are all the old weapons there? And are there new weapons?
I think all the old weapons are there. I'm not sure about new weapons. There's a lot of stuff you unlock through the secret unlockables menu.
Okay, gotcha.
I know the Infinite Rocket Launcher is available. It costs a stupid amount of money.
But weapon-wise, on your first playthrough, you didn't notice any major deviations? There weren't, weird lasers or anything? Or did they remove, any weapon you loved?
I don't think so. Let's see. Okay, we don't currently have access
this is where the demo started.
Okay. So it has.
Because you're going to go into the house first. Yeah.
Yeah, it's the very Resident Evil 7, or Resident Evil 8, rather.
Yeah.
Opening. Because in the original, of course, you just show up at the house with very little fuss.
Mm-hmm.
Get into a little tizzy.
Get in a little tizzy.
Hang on a sec. Okay, let me just check my accessories. Oh, we could have Lexington glasses as well.
What? Is that a type of glasses?
Oh, shit. Spoiling stuff now.
Spoilers.
Oh, we can only change costumes from the main menu, I'm afraid. We're sticking with Ashley's default costume.
Perfect.
I think her special one was the same equivalent she had in the original. She had a suit of armor for when to go with Leon's gangster suit. But I haven't unlocked that because you need to complete a couple of achievements to get it.
Gotcha. Yeah, I saw some, Capcom released some art of other costumes, which I don't know if those are pre-order bonus or what, but one was Leon wearing sort of a cop jacket to make it look like he was more back at the RPD.
Okay, yeah. Well, that was the unlockable costume in the original, but I don't think that's unlockable by default in this version.
Gotcha. And then there was one for Ashley where she looked like a scene girl, kind of like a Hot Topic circa 2009.
I'm not sure what that means, but just there's what there's Ashley's costume in this game. Her standard costume is the one on the left with the jacket, and then later on in the game, after she's been roughed about a bit, she ditches the coat and she looks a little bit more like how she looked in the original with the the sleeveless sweater.
That is not the scene girl outfit I was referring to.
Okay. Anyone home?
So like right off the bat, this has very you mentioned Resident Evil 7 vibes. Even the interior here, if you would have told me this was like the Baker House, I'd be like, sure, it was a room in the Baker House. Which is like immediately kind of more like spooky and oppressive than almost anything in proper Resident Evil 4. So is that like a big change you noticed throughout the entire game? And is that one you liked or did not like?
As I said in my review, which you can see right now on escapismagazine.com, it feels like the Resident Evil 4 remake takes the original, and if you can imagine a knob with camp on one end and sensible on the other, this turns that knob two notches to the right.
Okay, so sensible.
The campness has been pulled back a bit. I mean, I guess you can't, in the original Resident Evil 4, the game isn't like, it's like being kind of neutral at the beginning because it doesn't want to give away what's going to happen.
Yeah.
But this, for the remake, you could argue that people know what to expect because it's a remake. So it's going like straight horror from the start.
Yeah.
But it is very reminiscent of the Resident Evil 8 and Resident Evil 7 openings in terms of atmos and, you know, environment as well.
Get over how Leon looks so stupid.
He looks like a Gestapo officer with those glasses.
He does. He looks like the Nazi in Raiders of the Lost Ark. I don't like this man at all. Scavenger with the $2 dono. Thank you so much, Scavenger. So if you've never played Resident Evil 4, does this work?
I could never answer that question because I've played Resident Evil 4 so much. It plays like Resident Evil 2, I guess, the remake.
Yeah, I imagine it plays well, right? I mean, the demo played well. Like, it's nice to have full control of your character more so than you did in 2005. Yeah, I'd be curious. I don't know who on the Escapist staff. Well, I know folks like Casey hasn't played it, but I don't know if he's going to play this. But I would be interested to hear the thoughts of someone who's, if this is my first Resident Evil 4 journey.
Well, I'd be interested to hear them too.
Yeah.
Just as I'd like to get the reaction of someone who never played Silent Hill 2 to the Silent Hill 2 remake once it eventually.
Yeah, yeah.
Because my opinion of that's going to be completely tainted by my opinion of the original. You will not be getting an unbiased review of that from me, I tell you that now.
Do you think on your dossier for there, they say, big fan of Silent Hill 2, and then underneath says, never wants anyone to remake Silent Hill 2.
Yes, do not send to this person.
Give it to anyone but Bloober Team.
Actually, I had to go to the Bloober Team booth at GDC yesterday because we were looking at the Layers of Fear demo.
Oh, no.
But luckily, I don't think they made that connection while I was
good.
There. I think I was just another random media person to them.
Yeah. And if it was yesterday, it means it was like the last day of the show or the second last day of the show or whatever. And maybe they were just exhausted by that point.
Hang on. What's your situation? Hang on, I need to turn off the controller speaker. I forgot to do that.
Oh, no. What kind of stuff's coming out of the controller speaker? Just everything? Or is there like...
Yeah, I was just hearing the radio voice just heard was coming out of the controller speaker.
Ooh,
but there's quite a few... This game uses quite a lot of controller speaker stuff. Wait, is there no option? Oh, hang on. There we go. Controller speaker off. Because you'll hear like gunshot sounds coming out of the TV and the controller when you use a gun because the gun's really close to you, I guess.
Ah, gotcha.
All right, we got our shit back.
Oh my god, look at how much stuff we have. Is this just everything you finished the game with, or is this just like on New Game Plus you start with like...
No, this is what I finished my last playthrough with. So I've got a Broken Butterfly, a Black Tail, and a Striker, and an LE5.
Man, I did not use... Did I use the Striker?
I'm actually really low on pistol. I ended the game really low on pistol ammo. Oh, my default knife's broke.
Oh, no.
That was one of my
complaints. That's one major change is the infinite knife no longer exists. Is that right?
Yes, that's one complaint I had, the knife. And the other one is that I didn't actually devote time to in the review because there wasn't much space. Mm. Now there's crafting. You got crafting materials.
It's the year of our Lord 2023, of course.
Now
crafting.
A lot of our inventory space is taken up with crafting materials. So we can craft shit.
Is it like similar crafting to like the kind of light crafting of like village and stuff? Like that kind of bullshit?
Yeah, it's that sort of vibe.
Leon's scarf is so dumb. I'm a big fan of it. Zeeb says, hey Marty, did you know you're quoted on the Wikipedia page for Gordon Freeman? That can't be true. Unless someone updated it based on something we were making fun of him for in our current streams. Yahtzee, you will be happy to know that last Thursday we got to the boss of the game and couldn't finish it in time. So we are at the boss of the game.
So we're going to finish a whole stream to kill the final boss.
we'll have another game downloaded that we'll start afterwards. We'll like play a little bit of, because we don't want to start Half-Life 2 because obviously Casey will be out the next couple weeks. So we'll figure that out.
You're going to play Opposing Force.
I am quoted.
What do you
It was from something I wrote on oneup.com, which is a website that went under in 2012. OneUp.com Marty Sleeve included him among the most unrelatable narrators, stating, quote, I'm sure some people like the fact that they become Gordon Freeman. I just think I'd be a little bit happier if there was literally anything there to become. I don't remember writing that. I'm sorry, Gordon Freeman. I apologize, Gordon.
Well, there you go.
I believe we're going to start Black Mesa, because that was the game we had in the account. We didn't have Opposing Forces or... What's the bad one? The joke one people wanted us to play?
Hunt down the Freeman. Yeah, I wouldn't blame you if you didn't cover that one at all.
I mean, is it like so bad it's good, so bad it's entertaining?
I guess. Well, the cutscenes are, but then you have to actually play the game as well.
That's not good. I don't want that.
Yeah, this is all new. So they make the story slightly more sensible as part of the continuing remit to make things slightly sensible.
Sure, the seriousing things of all things.
So now we actually talk to Hunnigan like we're an actual secret agent with code names and everything.
Ooh, baby Eagle. I hope he jumps out the window.
Well, what do you think he's going to do?
I think he's going to jump out the window. I kind of cheated by saying that because I played
of course
he's going to jump out
the window. Which you could do in the original, but it was optional.
Oh, that's a fun fact.
It's the first time when you can jump out of a window. And obviously, if you can have your main character jump out of a window, you've got to mandate it.
Yes, 100%.
This is like the merchant's here, but this will only happen on New Game Plus. Otherwise, he shows up at the point in the game where he usually shows up.
How, obviously, a lot of the, if not every character has a new performer. How did you feel about that?
Well, it's the same sort of same accent. Little bit more South African. He's just a touch less overly enthusiastic.
Oh, I liked his enthusiasm.
And there's the infinite rocket launcher for a princely 2 million pesos, or pesetas, or whatever they are. Well, let's repair our knife while we're here. Good luck to you,
stranger. Scavenger with a Filar, don't know, thank you so much. If you're going to explore the whole experience of Half-Life, you have to share the good and the bad. No cherry picking. Play Hunt Down the Freeman. We'll save that. We'll save that maybe after, as like a little, as a digestif in between Half-Life Episode 2 and then when we move on to the portals. And yes, Pacific Blue, Casey has Black Mesa downloaded. I talked about it with him earlier. And Hannibal Lar with a $2 dono, thank you so much. Important question, can you still suplex monks?
Yes, you can. It's a little bit harder, though. I only did it once. I think you have to, as well as getting them on their knees, you have to approach them from behind, which is which is tough.
Yeah.
Because obviously they're all going to be coming towards you.
Mm-hmm.
Also, there is a stealth element in the game now,
mm-hmm.
which we'll probably get to have a chance to enjoy very soon.
How did you feel about the stealth stuff?
I guess it made sense.
Yeah,
because it's possible to like creep up behind an enemy without, if it's at all possible to creep up behind an enemy without them noticing you. I think it's just nice to have the option to stealth kill them. Because what else are you going to do?
I imagine you can't, like, get through entire... Like, I doubt you can get through that entire village thing by just stealthing people. But, like, it was nice when I was playing the demo that I went along the left-hand path, which I always do, to, like, the lady who's by the little, like, chicken shack. And it was nice to be able to stealth her, as opposed to just, like, I make noise and she turns around and then all hell breaks loose.
Yeah, because if there's no stealth kill, you just creep up behind them, and then you're like, well, now what?
Mason Daniel, been a member for 10 months, thank you so much. Have y'all seen Dave the Diver? Good on early access. Dave the Diver. Have y'all seen Dave the Diver?
I have not seen that.
Dave the Diver. Casual single-player adventure RPG. Oh, it looks nice. Kind of looks like... Oh, it looks like several things.
Oh no!
It looks nice.
He didn't make it.
No, that dog.
No, don't worry. That's not that dog. That dog shows up later in the game, and you rescue him in a different spot to where you rescued him in the first game.
Is he still in a bear trap? Also, how many bear traps did you get caught in? Because when I was playing, my lord, did I get caught in a lot of
bear
traps.
Quite a few. Although gratifyingly, they don't seem to take health off. They just hold you in place now.
Oh, that's nice. Man, I stepped in an embarrassing amount. Especially several just back-to-back.
I wasn't ready.
Oh, I thought that was like a death animation. I was like, Jesus.
Hey, I'm trying to parry you, you rude git.
John Marston, thank you so much for the donation. Can you use Leon's jacket for the entire game?
You can in a second playthrough, because you can go into the extras menu and select it as like the permanent costume.
Gotcha. Without any spoilers, were there any like major changes? Like, I know the trailers showed like Luis lives longer in this version than. Further on into the adventure than he does in the original.
He does, yes. As I said in my review as well, I think of all the characters, I think Luis is the one who has the best improvements in this game. Because in the original, he's kind of a non-character.
Yeah.
And he's kind of
a creepy horn dog.
Yeah, and he says, ay, ay, ay. there's quite a bit more to him in this game.
Mm.
I think in all of the cases, you know, everything just feels a bit like it's less camp and therefore less fun.
Yeah. Scavenger with a $5 donation. Thank you so much, Scavenger. I always wondered if the wolf/bear traps were supposed to be a call out to the dogs from earlier games. None of these. This isn't your daddy's Resident Evil. Well, there's dogs in this one. There's dogs in the hedge maze. Yeah. Oh, those dogs. Those dogs spooked the hell out of me.
And earlier on.
Yeah.
Okay, this was the way forward.
Watch out, there's got to be a man.
Oh, you bastard. Man, you're shit at not being parried, you are.
I like that the knife, you can even sort of like parry and hold it against the chainsaw, which, my lord, what a knife. What a brave knife.
I guess. Let's make some shit up.
Andrew Hickabottom with a £2 donation. Darn it, Marty, you promised us WWE 2023. Sorry, we got our wires crossed. I thought this was... Yahtzee said he got a code for a game that he was really looking forward to playing, and I thought it was WWE 2023. My mistake. Cookie Face says, funny how many assets are reused from the other games. I mean, I don't know. If you make, like, a table, well, you have to make a new table. Use the old table if it looks fine.
I suppose.
I don't know. I'm fine with reusing, like, if they built things for Resident Evil 2 and Resident Evil 3 remakes or Resident Evil Village, you can kind of put them in here. Like, I'd rather have their time spent, I don't know, building new things or doing new interesting things as opposed to being like, let's just do another table for the sake of doing a table.
Yeah, I imagine there's a lot of assets from RE Village being reused here. Oh, I thought you spotted me. Oh, well.
Wolfson, $6 Canadian, says message retracted. I'm not sure. What were you trying to say, Wolfson?
Sneaky, sneaky, sneak, 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 sneak.
Yeah,
sneak.
This is that lady.
Sneaky, sneaky, sneak, sneak. Stab, face. I should point out that the knife I'm using has been, like, upgraded for durability multiple times.
Oh.
So it won't be breaking terribly quickly.
So how does... So you can upgrade individual knives, or do you upgrade, like, a knife stat and then every knife you get?
No, you upgrade individual knives.
Gotcha.
I am carrying my starting knife, which is the one that you can repair, and Krauser's knife, which is slightly better.
Gotcha.
I think I'm currently using Krauser's knife.
You have a little tchotchke dangle at the bottom left-hand corner of your attaché case.
That's the reward for doing the shooting gallery.
Yay!
Which is still in the game.
Yay!
Everyone relax.
Yeah, apparently Mercenaries is not at launch.
No,
and
it is
same
not.
Thing where Ada's Bogus Adventure, whatever her thing's called, is also not at launch.
Separate Ways. Although some Separate of the cutscenes from Separate Ways made it into the default campaign.
Gotcha. You know,
well,
they said Mercenaries
a lot of
is going to be a free update. I don't know if they've said that Separate Ways is coming. I imagine it will.
Blimey, this is going to be easy. Use the pistol on you. That's how much contempt I have. Yeah, it's on Forestera. Die mad about it.
Wolfson. Oh, with the Canadian $16. Thank you so much. I was asking if the dog maze was still here, because that's one section I could do without. I like the dog maze.
The dog
I'm still
maze
the
is
every
here.
Hedge maze is,
the dog
hedge
maze is very much intact. I guess if you want to talk about significant removals, probably the biggest thing that got taken out was the boss fight with it. Which was always kind of a non sequitur.
Yeah.
But it was a memorable part of the game.
It was, yeah.
There's a chainsaw man on my tail somewhere.
Oh, no. Like the hit anime chainsaw man?
Oh, here he comes now. Oh, bloody hell.
He's chopping everyone. Whoa.
Yeah, he just doesn't give shit one. Hey, you burned down your own barn, you silly buggers.
Oh, no. I hope that bull's okay.
Oh, boy. Bad time.
I love that they hold you in place for... What's his name? Dr. Salvador? Is that his...
He's something like that. Dr. Salvador.
Uh, Zekrul asks, are the creepiest enemies in all of gaming still here? The regenerators?
Yep.
I've seen the I've seen footage of the regenerators, so I think they're definitely still here.
I think I need some more ammo. Shotgun shells it up.
I never knew what triggers the church bell ringing. Is it just time? Is it amount of things you've killed?
I think
it's
number of kills.
Okay.
And I think that number goes down if you die too many times.
Sure.
Oh, there we go. Hey!
Nice.
3 emerald. So this is where the demo ends, is it?
Yes, it ends with him saying the bingo line, which is
all right. Time for new shit.
New shit.
I'm streaming on the cutting edge at last. Look at me now, Mum.
Unless you're in New Zealand, in which case you can already download the game. So this is old shit for all of our UE friends.
Yeah, and there's already the fucking full run-throughs on YouTube.
Oh yeah, as soon as the embargo drops, there's certain channels that are just like, I don't know how they exist, but they're just like, here's the whole game, it doesn't matter. We don't need to abide by any embargo. Maximilius, with a $10 donor, thank you so much. I'm pleased to see that they kept at least one fun costume. Did they include all the fun weapons, like the infinite Tommy gun or rocket launcher as well?
Yes. Although you'll be paying through the nose for them.
I guess encouraging that whole multi-playthrough thing that the original had.
Hey, he said the line.
You did it.
All right.
Oh, someone earlier asked what you're playing on. You mentioned the PS5 controller, so PlayStation,
yes.
Correct?
I am on PlayStation 5.
Windmill. Copy that.
Yeah, I haven't noticed any big... It sounds like all versions of the game are fine. Doesn't seem like there's any one of those scenarios where one version's port is broken to high hell, so... Sounds like you should be fine no matter where you play it.
And now to smash all their shit.
Yeah.
So the layout of the village is largely faithful to the layout in the original. There's a building that you can't get into until you have Ashley to help you climb in. But otherwise, it's pretty much the same.
Is the layout of most of the game pretty familiar? Like,
a lot of it. There is, as I say, there's some set pieces have been cut out.
Okay.
Or they've been changed. Basically, all the puzzles are different.
Okay.
But the layouts of a lot of the environments will seem very familiar.
Would you say it's... I guess you probably don't remember Dead Space as well as you remembered Resident Evil, but like kind of where, if you had to put both of those on the spectrum, are they similar in terms of what they keep and what they change? Or
Dead Space is practically one-to-one.
Okay.
Except some of the areas are like have been adapted to the change in the zero gravity stuff.
Oh yeah, that's right.
But this game is a ground-up remake. Here it is. Here's the bit where we need Ashley. That wasn't in the original. Oh, and there's something else. Hang on. So, you played the original. Do you know what happens if you try to climb the tower to escape the villagers at the beginning?
You can do it fine, right? Whereas in this, when I did it in my demo, I fell through the floor. I think I either fell through the floor or someone cut through the beams or something.
Well, yeah. Well, in the original, if you went up here, they would throw Molotovs up at you.
Oh.
So in this case, the floor collapses. If you decide you're gonna hang out in the
okay,
tower.
I wasn't sure because I did it while they were chasing me, and I was like, "Oh, did the chainsaw guy like cut some beams or something?" But
no, that just happens.
Yeah.
I keep accidentally pressing the right trigger because the shoulder buttons on the PlayStation 5 are really sensitive, really very sensitive.
They're sweet. They're little. It's an emotional little controller.
Don't call them mean names.
Did you have any standout things at GDC that you're able to talk about?
I don't know. I can't really keep track of the embargoes. I can mention that I got to meet Ben Esposito, creator of Neon White.
Excellent.
Had a little interview with him. That might be on a video at some point. Because we were on the show floor and there was like an indie game showcase.
Mm-hmm.
And Tunic, Neon White, and Not For Broadcast were all right next to each other. So we hung out there for a while. Like,
so
chilling you
made
with
a little,
the devs.
A little Yahtzee's Row.
Basically. I think Case of the Golden Idol was there as well.
There you go.
That's the thing about GDC. It's mostly... the games you can play seem to be mostly like lower profile indie stuff.
Yeah, yeah. And even like a lot of the folks who attend, because I saw the last night there was like the GDC awards, and Elden Ring won Game of the Year, unsurprisingly, and Miyazaki just sent sort of a video message, but it was funny because he said that he recorded the message not knowing whether or not they would win, but he was like, "If you're seeing this, we won, so that's nice."
Yeah, it must be a strange position to be in. Just assume that. You're really happy about something.
Yeah.
Like at the moment that it gets announced, you'll either be really happy or disappointed. Just assume you're happy and respond appropriately.
It's also strange to like still be winning awards a full 13 months after your game came out. Oh, there, look at those little blue medals. I remember those guys.
There are blue medals in multiple parts of the game now.
Ooh, I always thought it was weird how those little things were only in, what, two sections?
Yeah, but I felt like it was more a sort of introduction to gunplay. And
yeah.
Aiming. Whereas in this game, it's sort of a recurring side quest that can get a little bit annoying.
Yeah, I think it was also like making sure that you knew you should be looking up and down and like. That there were multiple accesses you should be paying attention to in this game.
Hang on, there's a note to the effect. So spinels aren't quite what they were in the original. Spinels were just like the cheapest jewel you could find that you could sell for extra cash.
Oh, I was a big spinel fan.
In this game, the spinels are merchant tokens that can be exchanged for certain special items in the merchant shop.
Spinel exclusives?
Yeah. They're like fun bucks.
Yes. I would have absolutely walked right into that thing. Yeah. I would not have even thought twice into it.
And they can be disarmed without wasting a bullet on them.
Oh, that's nice. You just disarm them. You don't like get them in your inventory as like a trip mine or anything.
Probably
okay.
Make things a bit too easy there. I do have full health, so I don't even need yellow herbs. But I'm gonna use them anyway.
Scavenger with the $5 donation. Thank you so much, Scavenger. I'm going nuts trying to remember if it's ever explained why the church bell makes them just ignore you. I know why it rings, just not why it works.
Well, it's because they are. Part of the hive mind that worships this cult. And when the church bells, it's basically sending out an instruction to everyone saying, come to the church, all the cattle come to the church now.
Gotcha.
And they are powerless to resist, for they are hive minded.
Classic hive mind. Wolfson with another $6. Thank you so much, Wolfson. What's funny is I always found Leon the most relatable of the Resident Evil protagonists. In canon, he developed an alcohol addiction after Raccoon City, wouldn't you? Is that true?
Didn't Leah, they all?
In the bot. I imagine everyone would. Jill, I mean, definitely seems like she did.
That happened to Chris.
Not Chris. He's too buff. No, he's too buff.
No, in Resident Evil 6, at the start, Chris was sort of like burnt out. Because they literally just gave him an entire new backstory for Resident Evil 6.
What about Billy? Do you think Billy's fine?
Was
Billy... Like, I can't remember if Billy was in Zero. Or, no, Steve. Billy was in Zero and Steve was in Code Veronica. I think.
Yeah.
They were both weaned.
In 6, there was a new character who was Albert Wesker's son.
Oh, yeah. Oh, look at this guy. He's got a big-ass hammer. Who's this man? Oh, he's like the dude... He's like the dude from... Oh, my God. He's got a pig head?
Yeah.
Oh, he looked spooky. I don't like that man at all.
Yeah.
He looked like one of the dudes from Resident Evil 8.
This is one of the new Ben. Yeah. The new thingies. Unfortunately, he's not climbing up this ladder. Because I say he can't. Hi, everyone. Hey, I found some grenades. Want to look?
Nick, yeah, I like that change, too, that you could just... that there's just a button prompt to break the destructible boxes and crates instead of having to get your knife out to break them. It's a small thing, but I just like it.
Don't you mutate on me.
Hunter Crimson says, finally, appropriate Spain Spanish. That is funny. I guess I imagine, is like the Spanish better in this game? I'm sure neither of us know, but like, if there's anyone in chat who speaks Spanish.
I have no idea.
I imagine the Spanish in the original was probably not good.
No, it was Mexican Spanish. That was the joke.
Oh, and where it's supposed to be Spain Spanish.
Yeah. I guess they figured any Spanish was as good as any other, so everyone speaks Mexican Spanish in the middle of Spain. I mean, even like Luis says, ay, 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 which is... I looked it up, and apparently it's strictly a Mexican Spanish thing.
It's locked. Alpha 5, the robot from Power Rangers, also says it. Maybe he's Mexican Spanish as well. Well, he's a robot. I'm not sure what he is. James Hunt, been a member for 9 months. Thank you so much, James Hunt. Can't wait to replay the original RE4 again. It's never a bad time to replay. Except like maybe during, like if you're supposed to be like at court, that's a bad time to replay it. Or like if you're officiating a wedding and you're playing it, that's a bad time. Look at that. Nick's in the chat. I am alive. Oh, barely. Nick, how are you, Nick? Not alive, Nick?
There's the 5 medallions.
Yay! Oh, yes.
You see that thing on the windmill?
Yeah, was it a cowbell? Or a cheese grater?
Yeah. If you see those, shoot them, for they contain treasures.
Oh. Oh, if you would have shot it on the left-hand side, it would have fell in the pool water, and then you would have got a dirty necklace.
We've had a dirty pearl pendant, and that's not what we want.
No, those are not as valuable.
Yes, so if you see that particular sort of hanging cowbell thing, shoot them, for they contain treasures. You would probably not have realized that otherwise. Look at me giving out gameplay tips. Gameplay top
old
tips.
Old SEO wikis. Yahtzee over here. Oh, Nick has to be at the airport for 6 hours. Nick, you could have just enjoyed San Francisco for the afternoon and then went to the airport. There's so many things to do.
You could have gone to the piers and looked at the seals.
You could have went to the Musée Mécanique.
You could have gone to the Exploratorium.
Oh, my God, you could have explored? You could have went to the Cheesecake Factory. Ooh, Union Square.
There's a few places you could go to enjoy the Cheesecake Factory.
No, it's the only one in America. Union Square. Don't look that up. Danny D with a $4.99 dono. Thank you so much, Danny D. I hope whoever originally came up with adding the suplex button to Resident Evil 4 got a bonus. To be honest, anyone who worked on the first game probably did not receive any money. Although I am curious, like, what a guy like Mikami makes off this game. Like, I don't know what contracts are like, what they were like back then, but, like, Shinji Mikami, like, I assume he profits off this game, right?
I gotta hope so.
Yeah.
Because it probably means he can literally fund any project for the rest of his life.
He can fund his new studio, yeah.
Right.
Bunkers! Oh, sorry.
All our business with finding a gear to open the portcullis. That's all new.
Portcullis?
Now, the treasures. Treasures work slightly different to how they did in the original. You find, like, random treasures that can have things socketed into them, and you can socket them with any of the gems you found as long as they're the right shape. Mm. Whereas in the original, you could only socket specific jewels into certain treasures.
Gotcha.
So, and the different combinations give you different bonuses. Like, if we go, let's see, two, if we put a ruby in there, adds 3,000 pesetas, put in two rubies, we get a duo bonus, which multiplies the value by 1.2.
Oh.
Or we could slot in a blue one, which gives us the two colors bonus, which isn't quite as good as the doubled up colors bonus.
Oh, so using different colors isn't as valuable as using the same color.
Yeah. Yeah.
Interesting. That's different from the original, because the original you wanted one of each color.
Yeah. Right?
And that was the only thing you could do. You couldn't really force.
Here's how the values work.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's like cards. It's like hands of cards.
So if you got three colors is better than having two red ones, but three of a kind is better than having three different colors.
Ah! Incredible.
And of course, five different colors is the best of all, but treasures with five sockets in them are very rare indeed. All right, that'll drive you mad if you insist on selling everything for the maximum possible price.
There you go.
If you're that sort of person.
Honkers with 137.5 Philippine pesos, I believe. I was wondering about Yahtzee's view on Naoki Yoshida's comments on the term JRPG and if it was discussed in a previous live stream. We talked about that a couple weeks ago.
I know it was brought up by Stephanie Sterling recently. What have we been saying about JRPG?
Man, we talked about it on something. Maybe I just talked about it on a bunch of the other streams we were on. In the press tour for Final Fantasy 16, Naoki Yoshida talked about how for a long time there was an era where Japanese developers almost saw the term JRPG as like an insult or a slight, because as opposed to just being a signifier of like trying to differentiate between Western RPGs and JRPGs in terms of design structure and sort of battle mechanics and things like that, that people would almost like, and there was even one, I think there was like a BioWare developer or something who just referred to like JRPGs had a negative connotation to it as opposed to a positive, you know, as opposed to just a genre connotation. Whereas I feel like now if you use the, like, I don't know, I use the term, and when I use it now, I don't obviously have it loaded with any connotations. It's just to separate the kind of game to expect, whether it's Persona or, you know, Mass Effect or something like that.
Oh, there was one behind me. They keep doing that.
Sneakies.
Always listen out for when they say, look behind you, idiot, in Spanish.
I don't even know what that is in Spanish.
Well, if you hear something that sounds like it ends with imbecil, which means idiot, that means there's something coming up behind you. Let's turn around.
Oh, like imbecile. I thought you meant like embezzle, like to embezzle money. And I was like, oh no, that's not good. Scavenger with $5 dono, thank you so much. Thing I learned, Mikami wrote the script for RE4 in 3 weeks and didn't like how it turned out. He said he hoped the remake would make a better story.
Well, I guess it kind of shows. But you know, often like the appealing campness of these sorts of things are very rarely intentional.
Yeah.
So, dudes,
I don't know though. I think
houses...
in modern games, I think camp is intentional in modern games. Like that Wanted Dead. I have to imagine the camp in that game is intentional.
You gotta hope so. Come on, Don Manuel.
I think Japanese developers have a sense of humor that is misunderstood.
Well, it's often the case with a foreign culture that, you know, their language has subtleties that makes their humor work in ways we can't really appreciate.
Sure.
Alright, who's got the fucking dynamite out?
Johnny Dynamites.
Shoot in the head, then karate kick. It's the classic move.
We'll sell another $15 Canadian. Thank you so much. By the way, Yahtzee, it's funny that you brought up Chris earlier. Did you know that his whole backstory is that he's ex-Air Force, thrown out for reckless behavior and punching his CEO? It's literally Discount Doom guy. Wait, he was in the Air Force like before Resident Evil 1?
Yeah, yeah, that's dumb. This is like something that seems to come up a lot in Resident Evil and that sort of thing. Everyone seems to have had three careers before like the age of 18.
Incredible.
And like the dates just don't add up for the characters' ages. I mean, you have to... I think Jill Valentine was like former Delta Force or something like that. You don't just like go straight from high school to Delta Force.
Yeah.
Takes a few years.
I also like that with Resident Evil Zero, like Rebecca went through an entire zombie scenario and wasn't like, oh, hey guys, by the way, there's like a shit ton, there's like some crazy zombie stuff going on. I just dealt with it yesterday.
This is why I appreciated Isaac Clarke and his girlfriend being middle-aged in the Dead Space remake.
Yeah.
Because, you know, they're professionals, the top of their field, with a lot of experience.
Maybe everyone on Stars is a Nepo baby. And that's ultimately what Mr. X is after, is to kill all the Nepo babies.
Oh, that was a bear trap.
Ah, classic bear trap.
Well, we're going to have to deal with that dynamite chucker on the roof. Now that I've finally spotted them. Sometimes it takes a while to spot where the dynamite chuckers are. Stop ducking.
Scavenger, yes. Nepo babies are nepotism babies.
Yes, Harrison Novak. I'm afraid they did cut out. No thanks, bro.
No! How dare they?
They cut out a lot of the banter between Leon and the villains. Device where the villains hack into his comms device and taunt him over the course of the game, which was where most of the really like classic shitty dialogue lines appeared.
Yeah,
that just doesn't happen. They don't taunt him over his comms device. So by the time Leon confronts Sadler at the end of the game, they barely know each other. They've barely interacted.
That's kind of a bummer.
I know. What happened to the chemistry?
Yeah. It also seems like that's a relatively easy thing to keep. Like, those are just... Like, I don't know, how does this handle, like, radio calls? Like, does it go to a cutscene, or does it...
Well, you've seen them already. You see, like, the image of...
Oh, the little Hunnigan's... thing in the bottom.
Yeah, Hunnigan's face appears in the middle of the screen. But no, after we lose contact with Hunnigan, that stops happening. Oh, I think Luis and Ada give you a couple of calls after that. But no villain taunting over the radio. Sorry.
Yep. I would have also worked right through that one. I don't pay attention to any tripwires in games.
You'd probably have heard the beep beeping.
Okay, that is true.
Now, who do we think that weirdly square-headed child is?
That's my favorite little man. Is that my favorite little man?
I'm not sure. I think that might be Sadler, actually.
Oh, never mind.
The main
villain. My favorite little man. What's
that noise? Although, as I say, by the end of the game, we've barely interacted with the dude, so who can say?
Palash T with a $2 donation. Thank you so much. Playing Resident Evil Village right after Resident Evil 7, big step down. Yeah, I mean, it's much less survival horror and much more like theme park action.
More gothic.
Yeah.
Well, it's doing its thing. But yeah, Resident Evil 7 certainly felt like the much tighter experience.
Yeah.
I mean, there are bits of Resident Evil 8 that are amazingly well done.
Yeah, the House Beneviento.
It's just got you know, just a big smashed together mess.
I thought that entire factory thing was with Heisenberg was pretty dumb. And that went on a very long time.
Haha, we hear, in the original, we hear banging from the house, and it turns out to be Lewis banging on the inside of a wardrobe that he has been trapped in. In this version, it's the cultist nailing a trapdoor shut after having shut Lewis in the basement. It's all different. You got to buy the new one.
Everything's new.
Hey, there's the village elder.
Also, as an adult, it's really embarrassing to be locked inside of a cabinet or a wardrobe, so they let Luis keep some of his dignity by just having a sack put on him. Chapter end.
There you go.
The end. His outfit. So every time this close up of his outfit, it's so dumb.
Wondering how that scarf is staying on.
Stop it. It's impressive, I'm gonna say. Genuinely impressive.
Got your name? Leon.
Quiet, eh? Wolfson with another $620 Canadian. Thank you so much. The silliness aside, I always thought getting cut off from the supervisor made Leon come off as more competent hero, able to handle himself.
Okay. If you like.
That's why you can still be competent and then have to fucking banter with all sorts of weirdos.
Yeah. I mean, he comes across.
No, he looks like Leon. Looks like Christopher Lloyd in Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
Oh yes,
that's what he looks like.
Because he looked like a
Gestapo. Because he looked like a Nazi as well.
Well, he certainly dressed for the interrogation at this point.
Oh man, they're just going down on this man.
Yeah.
Husky Highlander with a $10 dono. Thank you so much, Husky Highlander. People dislike the banter in Atomic Heart and Forspoken, but this game could really use the campy banter. What's the difference? Is it nostalgia or is it something else?
Well, Resident Evil is an inherently campy B-movie sort of franchise. Also, those two games are kind of badly written.
Yeah. The you can also get to a point where things are overwritten, like characters are talking too much, which is what I felt from the opening of, honestly, the opening of both games were just very talky. I still don't think, I think Forspoken has a litany of problems. The whole banter thing, I don't even think is near the top of my list of the problems that game had. That game design issues.
It's one of the more visible ones.
I think it's one of the easier ones to clip out specific moments and get people to rally the wagons around. I almost said wally the wagons. Wally the wagons. Atomic Heart, it is. Right from the get-go, you're like, oh, this man needs to stop talking. I do not like being this man.
So as well as the IKEA default knife that you can repair, you can also pick up flimsy disposable knives to redress the balance a bit. Like the one we just picked up.
Oh, so you have disposable knives, and then you also have a knife that breaks but you don't like lose it from your inventory. That's the one you can upgrade. Yeah,
the one you can repair.
Gotcha. Repair and upgrade. Gotcha.
So we've been stripped of weapons, as would be sensible, I suppose. But we can grab some temporary knives, and as is always the case with these sequences in modern games, we get all our stuff back in like 2 minutes anyway.
Yay! I missed my stuff.
Yes.
Sweep kick, very good.
A deadly.
Yeah, just really killed that man.
Oh, here's the fucking rat.
What's the deal with the rat?
Well, we'll find out.
Does he have like a key in his stomach?
Just gonna have to. There we go. That's one dead.
One of three.
Yeah. Well, if you haven't seen my review, there's a point in this game where I literally said "fuck you" out loud.
Was it when you needed to kill three rats?
It was the point when I saw a piece of paper saying "kill three rats."
This is my favorite MMO opening area.
I'm sure a lot of other people would have had similar sentiments.
Is it a requirement, or is it like a side quest?
It's a side quest, but just, you know, putting it in the game at all felt almost insulting.
Because you've seen the movie Ratatouille and you've like become affectionate to rats?
No, because it's just a dumb busy work quest. Who the fuck cares if we kill three rats? We're supposed to be saving the president's daughter. Okay, rat, you get to live.
Are there only three rats, or are there like many rats throughout the game, and once you've killed three of them, the game acknowledges your success?
I think there's only three rats in this particular area, and those are the three we have to kill for this quest.
Yeah, what do you get for killing three rats? Do you get like a rat gun?
You get spinels. You get fun bucks.
I fucking love spinels.
For the merchant.
I do love spinels. But yeah, I mean, do you think it's any different than the blue medals in the original? Like,
well, as I said, the blue medal was like a one-time thing. It was a way to teach you how to shoot, and it gave you the Punisher if you were that interested.
Okay.
But this is just, you know, little fussy add-ons.
It's also, I'm getting secondhand angry for you because of how fussy this game is being with, like, there should just be, I approach the rat and hit a button and it's dead.
Yeah, I should be able to stomp on it. Like, you should Isaac be able Clark. To absolutely stomp it. Okay, it died then.
3 of 3.
You get spinels for killing them, Clown 073. I'll show you what the spinels can buy next time we reach the merchant, which should be very soon.
Listen, that was frustrating. Everything's going to be fine though once we get those hot spinels.
So there's more than a couple of side quests. A lot of them along those lines, just kill three random animals. Some of them are kill one of a special kind of monster that has now spawned in an area you've already been. So you have to go back there and kill them.
Do you have
to... And the blue medallion quest shows up again and again throughout various points in the game as well.
Do you have to like accept the quest, or is it just... Like, it's just the quest is just there. Like, how does that work? Like, you just killed a rat and it said one of three. Like, okay.
Yeah, you have to find little notes to find out about them, but you're basically already opted in.
Over here, stranger. Nick wants to know that he's laughing at you trying to kill a rat in an airport bar.
It's very funny, isn't it?
He is the one in an airport bar. You aren't the one trying to kill an airport bar rat.
Oh. It's very, very funny that I keep killing the rats.
Spinel.
Hey, lots of spinels. Alright, so here's what you can trade spinels for. Yellow herbs, special gems. Here's the Punisher, if we wanted it.
Does it still do the same thing where it goes through, the bullets go through?
There's different colored attaché cases that have different effects. Ooh. In this case, increases the drop rate of certain kinds of herbs. This is how you buy the treasure maps for each area.
Oh, perfect.
You can just get treasures to swap for straight cash, a couple of unique guns, high power scope, and some treasures you can slot gems into, if you're so inclined.
These are Spinel exclusives.
Yes.
Wonderful. Nick Sisson says the inventory looks a lot bigger in the remake. Well, this is New Game Plus, so I'm assuming you have a fully upgraded attaché case. That's why it looks very large.
When
you were first playing, were you coming across times where you were like, shit, my stuff's full, I need to make decisions on what to get rid of?
Once or twice. Here's the Killer 7, by the way.
Ooh!
The laser sight.
Not a great gun.
The laser sight isn't on your gun by default in this game. You have to buy one.
Oh.
In fact, it's one of the spin-all trade items. And it only works on the pistol and the Punisher.
My back is killing me. Years haven't been kind to us, I suppose. Came into some other
people. Right, let's sell the flagon with the dragon.
Flagon with the dragon?
Yes, that contains the brew that is true.
Oh, I don't know what's going on, but I love this.
Okay, I need three. Aha, you do have some rectangular jewels on offer, so I will take one so that I can complete this treasure.
Wolfson, with 220 Canadian dollars, almost forgot. How was the Krauser fight this time?
Not so many quick time events.
No.
Because there's knife parrying mechanics, instead of the whole quick time event sequence, he just comes out here and you parry him a lot.
Oh, okay, so it's more of like a video game.
Yeah.
That's nice.
All right. That should boost the value a bit.
Wonderful.
Let's inlay the mask as well. Then I don't expect we'll make enough money for the infinite rocket launcher, but it's nice to have Dosh.
There you go. Hello there, Josh. Radioactive Jawa, what's up, Fran? Hello, guys. I hope you're enjoying this visit to Spain's most cursed location. Fran, you'll be happy to know Fran is one of our newest contributors at Seascapist, and is located in actual Spain. You'll be happy to know there's actual Spanish in this game.
Apparently. Not that we know.
I feel like someone in chat said that. So either chat lied to us, or I mean, chat might have. I'm gonna be honest. There's a very good chance chat lied to us.
All right. Yeah. Treasures.
Oh, Nick wants to know if the stare at the water spot is still in the game, or shoot into the water spot. He got tricked in when he played the game in VR.
I don't know if shooting the water has the same effect. I thought about trying it out, but it'd been a while since a save point, so I was paranoid.
Okay. I'll try it out when I get there this weekend, and I'll report back.
Not sure we'll get that far. We've got the whole mountain cliffside sequence to deal with now. I'm not really rigged for long range combat. I didn't really maintain a rifle.
Yeah.
Because your pistol's basically perfectly accurate anyway, so it's not really worth the bother.
Yeah.
I had like the shotgun for close range, pistol for all round, and I got the broken butterfly for when I really needed to make a serious impact.
Do you, you said you played at just on the whatever standard normal difficulty. Do you think it was pretty comparable challenge to what you'd expect if you went through the original game?
I can't remember. I think it might be a touch harder.
Mm.
Like the enemies have a couple more tricks up their sleeve.
Yeah.
Like the charge.
I saw some stuff where like they'll, if you like duck from one of their throned axes, they'll like feign a throw. And then if you duck, they'll throw it again and, like, lower. Sneaky little guys.
Sneaky little Spanish peasants. Come and get me.
Peasants, but they have a very intricate, like, cliffside village system here. I don't know what's going on here.
Yeah. What is this area supposed to be? They just call it the Valley.
Like, they all, I'm assuming they all live in that initial village, but like, well, yeah, what's, is this like a mine?
I don't see how it could be.
I don't know.
Haha, you're half the man you used to be.
Ah, waka waka.
Oh man. Oh, who's throwing dynamite around? How antisocial. Oh, it's you.
Wolfson, another dono. Thank you so much, Wolfson. Yahtzee, I'd like to ask your opinion on the voice acting this time around. It's a small thing, but I feel like I'd miss Matt Mercer's Leon.
Well, I do too, because, as I say, it's all, like, more serious and less camp now.
Yeah. Oh, Paul Mercier. Not Matt Mercer.
Leon in this game just feels like bland, generic action hero to me. Original Leon felt like a dude who was really trying hard to seem like an action hero, but was basically insecure. Hey, stop shoving. That's very rude.
Oh no.
This is a very densely populated village. I mean, how many houses were there in that village? Like, five?
Yeah, not a lot. Maybe they were just basements. You didn't go in. Basement apartments.
Maybe like the local castle had a very, very large live-in staff.
Turns out this is just right around the corner from the castle from Resident Evil Village.
Yeah, I assume so, because they were both set in the same place, open quotes, Europe.
It's like every Kojima game where it's like, now we're going to South America. What does that mean? Where are we? Gotcha. Matt Mercer voiced Leon later on in the series. While Nick Mercier, Paul Mercier. Well, that's weird that they went from a Mercier to a Mercer. What's going on here?
That's certainly Capcom,
get your shit together.
Things.
Very confusing.
Who's flinging shit? Show yourself, coward. I will not remove this hat.
Andrew Hickabottom with a 5-pound donation. Man, I've missed old-timey brown games. No forced splashes of magenta or teal paint, dust or smoke to be seen. This game does seem like it's maintaining the brownness of the generation.
Well, they did put yellow paint on the barrels, so you'd know what to break.
I think that's great.
Oh, you're up there, are you?
On Team Pro yellow paint. Yeah, I think I went straight from this game to Twilight Princess, which are two games that epitomized the brownness of the era.
Uh-oh.
Oh, where did that come from?
Ooh, a little bit of a... Did you see the little glitch out in the animation there?
Yeah. Well, you got a lot of herbs. That's good.
Well, that's the bloody hell. No, I got, like, grabbed a couple of times. I don't think an enemy was ever able to successfully exploit the fact that I'd been grabbed. All of them, they just sort of stood there and watched.
Yeah, I don't know what the, like... I get the chainsaw guy could, in theory, cut you in half if someone grabs you, but, like, what was that old lady gonna do when you were grabbed?
Stab me with something, maybe.
Crafty old lady. Crafty granny.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Oh, does the game have a quick turn? Says Slip Chicken. Asks.
Can't remember. I think it did. I just didn't really register what button it was.
What was it, the original game? Backwards and it was like down and... I actually don't remember.
You bore me. Ow. might as well use up these first aid sprays we found.
Delicious. I assume that the first aid spray was like Banaka. Leon was just putting a bunch of it in his mouth.
Yeah. Just filling his face. Put down that dynamite. You are not responsible enough.
What?
That's where it came from, isn't it? Ow.
No.
My God, you're ugly. Yes, that's where the merchant was.
Someone earlier asked what's the streaming schedule for the rest of the week. We have, Casey and I are finishing up Half-Life later tonight. It's starting at 7 p.m, so like a little under 3 hours from now.
Ooh.
And then tomorrow, Frost and I, the streaming embargo will be up for Dredge, so Frost and I will be playing some Dredge at noon tomorrow.
How is this guy not alerted? Seriously.
Maybe he has poor hearing and misplaced his hearing aids.
What are you dynamite people doing?
No adventures live tomorrow because folks are getting ready for the trip. Cool. Saturday, Frost is doing Wishlist and there's going to be a game night. And then there's no Amy stream on Sunday because I believe Amy's going to be already traveling.
Oh yeah, she's got a long way. She's got a long way to go, does Amy? Yeah. I remember doing Australia to America.
Pretty brutal. It's pretty brutal.
I learned how to sleep on airplane seats pretty well from that time in my life.
It's tall. It's tough too, being tall.
Yeah. Well, usually that's why I'd always like try to get the egg zero.
Yeah. Andrew, do I know what tomorrow night's game night is going to be? I sure don't. Something we'll probably try to figure out tonight.
They just keep coming. There's no stopping them.
You should be able to get a portable bell, so you can like ring the bell and then they'll all think that it's dinner time or whatever, wherever they all went before.
Like that dude who was like the first boss in Bloodborne.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you could Father Gascoigne's music box or whatever the hell it was.
There's a lot of yelling going on that I don't seem to be involved with. Is that one dumb guy throwing dynamite all over the place?
Dumb dynamite.
He keeps doing it. I think he's on my side. Thanks. Thanks, dynamite throwing man. Look, he's still alive, but the bad music that means an enemy is around has stopped. Which means he must be my friend. I guess he came back, actually. Alright, you die now. Shoot the dynamite out of their hand. Pro move.
Pro move.
Oh shit, she's alive. How do you still have a hand?
You still have a body.
How do you still have dynamite?
Speaking of, I know that was a bot in Twitch. I don't have any privileges on the Escapist Twitch, so I can't do anything about it. So that bot just gets to live on Twitch. I don't know what to tell you, Speakeasy.
Alright, bye bye. I'll just leave them to have a very firm conversation with their dynamite throwing friends. Oh, hey, a puzzle.
Oh, this is new. Scraw! Scraw! Perfect. Andrew Hickabottom, Marty, what's your next personal game stream going to be? It's going to be this, yeah. I'm starting this. I'm going to be jamming through this on stream. And then Skyward Sword.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, see, I've played all the major Zelda games, and I'm all the way up to Skyward Sword now.
That's Let me tell quite you. A few.
A lot of Zelda. A lot of Zelda. A lot of Link, a lot of Ganon, a lot of horses.
Did you do all the Zelda? Did you do Oracle
I did all the mainline
and
ones.
And Oracles of Ages?
I did all the mainline ones. Those are...
Come on.
I did all the ones that released on home consoles.
Why didn't the stealth kill prompt appear? I demand a refund.
Scav G, yep, I did Zelda 1 and 2. Both NES ones. Stun Aid with a $2 dono. Did they add a way to store your weapons?
Yes. I believe.
Oh, they did.
I believe you at save points them? You can store things.
Oh. Incredible.
Although I never did. Maybe because I'm just used to playing the original.
Wolf Son, yes, canonically, Skyward Sword is the first Zelda game.
Chronologically, you mean?
Chronologically. Well, and canonically, I guess, right?
I suppose.
Does that work? Chronologically was the word I was looking for, though. Scavenger, I did not play the CDI games. I've actually never played those. I'd probably just watch a video of them. Mouse Catcher. I got this really cool book at my bookstore. I don't know if you've heard of it. It's called Existentially Challenge. Oh, it's in bookstores.
My new book is in bookstores. As I say, we're still waiting on the ebook version. But you can get the print version right now if you want. If you're some kind of caveman from olden times.
I still like my print books. Oh, am I a caveman from old times?
I guess I should probably plug it somewhere, like on Twitter. Hey, remember this puzzle?
I do. I failed it. I failed it the first time, and I succeeded the second time because I learned the error of my ways.
Oh, not you. I hate you. I'm going to broken butterfly your ass. Oh, bugger. Oh, God. Ah. Oh, God.
Do you think Leon's going to be all right?
It was only because of that fucking bear trap.
Don't you dare blame the bear trap. The bear trap did do its job, I guess.
He didn't get decapitated.
Miriam, sad. Thank you so much for the donation. Need to fix my attention span. Does anyone know a good long book? What about Existentially Challenged? Now in bookstores.
Yes, I've heard that one's good.
I don't know how long it is, though.
It's a sequel to Differently Morphous.
If you combine them, that's probably a longer book.
A wonderful novel by Yahtzee Croshaw.
Incredible.
Okay, I'm determined to broken butterfly this man now.
What's your longest book, word-wise?
I don't know. I try to keep them around the same length. So they're all around 100,000 words.
How long is a zero punctuation script?
I'm not sure. It's 5 minutes.
Yeah, but you talk very quickly. Wolfson with another dono. Thank you so much. So then would you say the remake is less challenging with experience of playing the original?
Oh, shit.
You kind of know what to expect, so I feel like there's an inherent, like, if you've played the original, you are prepared for the scenarios the game's going to throw at you. you sort of understand its flow in terms of when to fight, when to run, how to conserve things.
Well, you might get caught off guard by the charge attack.
Sure.
I certainly was.
Uh-huh.
And you sort of have to learn how to parry as well. Because that's new.
Yeah, that seems like one of the most different.
Oh,
bear trap.
Yes, thank you. I see it now.
Oh, they're coming. Oh, he's coming. Just going to give me a big old hug. I cannot fathom how many bear traps I'm going to fall into. Oh my
Where do these guys keep coming from?
New little portals. Maybe they're all coming from Zen. Also, holy moly, Zen, what a terrible place. Why would anyone live there? It's
you
awful. You
understand how it was much derided as a finale of the game.
People said in Black Mesa it's like twice as, it's like much longer. Like better, but longer.
It's had a lot of tweaking. Almost feels like an entire separate game. Because Black Mesa was available on Early Access for years without Zen. It just cut off before the Zen bit. So they really put the effort in so that people would be impressed when they finally added it in. Hey, do you remember in the original you could go into a room in the Chieftain's house and there'd be a dude on the toilet?
No, I did not actually.
Well, here he is!
Ah, toilet dude!
Hey, I shot you in the head, you bastard. That means you stagger. That's the rule.
I remember there's the room that you leave, and then if you turn around and go back in the room, you get the secret cutscene.
No secret cutscene this time. They just sort of merged the two cutscenes together. Mm-hmm. The normal one and the secret one.
Gotcha. Mr. John Rayosha, thank you so much. I've been a member for 34 months. Have you guys seen the Resident Evil 4 anime promotions that Capcom made? I have. I think they're delightful.
They're very sweet.
Yes.
Bit short.
Yeah.
Ooh, puzzles.
Look at those animals.
Puzzles.
Line up all the animals.
Puzzles, puzzles, puzzles.
Also, our game glitched out at one point several times last week. The big bull boss that you have to fight throughout Zen, like in a couple different phases.
Oh, yeah.
There's one point, I think, in like right before the last phase where you kind of fight on this webbing and then the webbing breaks and you have to fight in a little arena. It just wouldn't go forward into that area with the webbing. And so we had to reload an earlier save to get it started.
Huh.
Apparently people in chat said that that's a place that is notoriously bugged. So
yeah, it's true.
We got through it. We powered through it. Damien Gled said he distinctly remembers me going into that room with the guy with the bathroom when I was streaming it and commenting on it. So apparently I did know about that room. Again, a whole month ago. Am I supposed to remember stuff from a month ago? Get out of here.
Okay. Puzzle, puzzle, puzzle. Crop, pig, baby. That's the combination.
Crop, pig, baby.
Crops, pig, baby. Lesser known prog rock band. So, crop, pig,
baby.
Baby. There we go. And now we get a thing to solve another puzzle with. We're puzzle mad around these parts. Oh, bugger. Get back in the toilet, you. Where you belong.
Jason Foley with €5 dono. I remember me and my older brother playing the Wii version of the original Resident Evil 4 back in 2007. That version made great use of the motion controls.
Yes, I've heard a lot of people found that version pretty definitive.
I love waggling. Love to waggle.
All right. Let's get this over with.
What is happening here?
It's this clue? Puzzle, but a lot more complicated.
Oh, man. There was one of those Resident Evil... a puzzle I had so much trouble with in Resident Evil 7 were those, like, shadow puzzles where you had, like, a weird shape and you had to rotate it so that its shadow looked like a thing. I was my brain was not wired to be able to do that. An SVS guru with a 2 euro dono, thank you so much. Is Gonark derived from Gonad Monarch?
It's entirely possible. That's
the thing that thing looked like a little like a ball sack spider.
Yeah,
that's what it looked like. Oh, secrets. Purple Marauder, I've been a member for 9 months. Thank you so much. So do you recommend the game Yahtzee? I have not played the original. You should watch Yahtzee's 3-minute review, now available for early access members on Patreon and YouTube, or for free via the escapist.com website.
It's more than 3 minutes.
Oh yeah, your reviews aren't 3 hours. Never
it's
mind.
A zero
apologies.
Punctuation.
My apologies. My apologies. They're different things. Yeah, everyone got mad at me. Listen, I gotta deal with a lot of shit, everyone. Fucking cool it. Y'all gotta cool it.
The blood has accepted the gift.
Hey, it's a character.
Ada Wong. Ada Wong.
Much more soberly dressed than she was in the original.
Does Ada have costumes you can change?
Not that I found. Maybe that's going to be an unlockable.
Ooh.
Gift. My blood.
Yeah, you just try to gather your dignity, Leon, mate. Can't continue the game because the game wants to tell me things.
Ooh, chapter 3. Look at you.
See, in the original, Luis claims to be an ex-cop, but I think he was probably lying about that. And that never comes up in this game.
Does he just lie a lot?
I guess. The most unlikely people in Resident Evil games turn out to secretly be Umbrella research scientists, don't they?
That is true. That is true. If you meet someone new in the games, you should sort of just assume that that is their job.
Just face plant through this door. Oh, I think I hear that dog.
You too, huh?
There Aww. You go, that dog.
Oh my god, incredible.
Thanks, that Leon.
Take care of yourself, buddy.
And it's good because it's good that it's later on because by this point, Leon can really empathize with the dog because you've gotten caught in so many bear traps.
There you go.
Leon's like, no, I understand. I understand, yeah. Big fella.
Happens to the best of us.
Also, this is unrelated, but I noticed that your extra punctuation on the Everything games
yes.
went up today for everybody. And the timing of it was serendipitous because a bunch of previews and news dropped about that Everywhere game, the Leslie Benzies, who a former producer on the Grand Theft Auto series, formed their own studio and is making a game that is supposed to be like an everything game that has games inside of it. And reading that and then seeing your video go up, I was like, oh, that's nice timing.
Some people never learn.
They don't.
You can't just do everything. That way lies madness.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, now we've got the key. We can go inside the little chapel building there and everything will be fine.
What blimey. Oh, no. Oh, no. That's neat.
Physics.
Incredible.
And now dogs.
Like red, it's like red faction. And there's dogs. Oh my god, this is all new. Well, this is incredible. I didn't expect any of this. Simple Simon with a $2 dono. Thank you so much. The remake, do anything fun with the PS5 controller? Any cool rumbles? Got any good rumbles going on?
Yeah, there's a fair share of rumbles. And there's the speaker controller speaker stuff if you're into that.
Cool colors? Does it change with like your health? Like, is your controller red now or yellow now because your health is low?
No, it seems to be green at the moment.
Yeah. Really dropped the ball on that one, Capcom.
Uh-huh.
Lucas Root, been a member for 19 months, says, Leon with the fedora and glasses makes me think of early Yahtzee. Do you feel like you're role-playing
fair
right
enough.
Now?
Although, no beard.
I don't think Leon could grow a beard. Neither is anything wrong with that. I just don't think
you should. Somebody use some of these fucking healing items.
You have a lot of them.
I have a feeling some people will be disappointed that there's an auto sort button. I think a lot of people just liked doing that to relax.
I mean, you could do it. You could just ignore the button. Ooh, that sorted very quickly.
Yeah. Don't mess with Leon like sorting foo.
Kamja Ninja with a $2 dono. Thank you so much. So what's next for Capcom? Resident Evil 5 remake? Would they dare?
I
don't know.
I can't imagine they would.
Just make Resident Evil 5 and just make it a different game. Just call it Resident Evil 5. Just
yeah.
Ignore Resident Evil 5 and 6.
Do what the Abe's Odyssey people did. Oh, bugger.
Oh, where did she come from? Granny.
It was dark. I couldn't see.
Yeah, people want justice for Code Veronica. That game kind of sucks, honestly.
Code Veronica was just, you know, another hashing out of the usual formula.
Yeah.
Take a character from the first or second Resident Evil game by throwing a dart at a wall. And then zombie outbreak, big wall of snot in a lab. Hello.
Andrew Hickenbottom with a £2 donut wants to know how did Toffee cope without you, Yahtzee? I mean, that was just a warm-up because Yahtzee was still going home every day.
Oh, yeah.
Toffee's going to have separation anxiety for the next 2 weeks.
Well, he's not as bad as he used to be. He will tolerate being ministered to by my wife. But I'm sure he'll be full of happy wiggles when I come back.
No.
Oh, bloody snakes.
Oh, the snakes are back.
I love snakes. Yeah, remember those.
They still got eggs inside of them?
I don't think so. I think you just pick them up and can just eat them as a healing item by themselves.
Snake eater.
Yum, yum. And don't worry, there's the side quest somewhere to kill X amount of snakes.
Yay. Tsunami Doucher with a $10 dono. Thank you so much. One of my favorite quotes from Yahtzee is, a game that promises you could do anything focuses on nothing.
That certainly sounds like me.
Was that from your video today?
No, not today. Or something else, probably. But yeah, the point is that what's most important is the primary gameplay loop. What the player's doing on a moment-to-moment basis. Not grand ideas of unrealized potential. That's a big old skull.
Is that a giant skull? Were the gigantes, were those just dudes who grew? Or were those like indigenous species of like large, big-footed men?
I assume they were dudes who grew. They were given the magic parasite. Spoiler alert.
The ground is very misty. What is going on here? This is like a Spirit Halloween store.
Hang on. I can hear something.
What is it?
Aha!
Was it the cheese grater? What kind of a noise was it making?
It makes a sort of a creaking sound, consistent with something dangling on a rusty chain.
So there you go. Chat, when you're playing the game, keep your ears open.
Oh, my back. I was in terrible back pain after GDC. Running from hotel to hotel to get shown things. And those bloody mix events where you have to stand in front of the machine to play the game, because if they gave you a chair, you'd never fucking move.
Don't you worry. Milwaukee, big fans of sitting. Love sitting there.
I'm sure.
So many seats. So many seats. Got my hands on a fine piece of kit, I did. Scavenger with the $2 dono. Thank you so much. Odin, either of you try the Pale Beyond? No, that was the one we talked about a little while ago. That's like the what's it called? The Terror. Like the ship that gets stuck in the Arctic. No.
I forgot to mention, the Mine Thrower from the original game is gone and is replaced with the Bolt Thrower, which has a more general usage. See, since nobody ever used the Mine Thrower in the original, the Bolt Thrower is a gun it's quiet, it's got retrievable ammo, and you can just craft explosive darts for it to give it the same functionality as a Mine Thrower.
Oh, interesting.
But I never used it because I never did it in the original, so who cares?
So is a Bolt Thrower like ostensibly a crossbow?
I guess.
But with reusable ammo?
It's quiet and it immobilizes enemies.
It's a quiet thing, that'd be nice.
And the ammo can be retrieved and reused.
That, I feel like that's one of the... That's a nice selling point.
Have a pearl pendant, you grabby bastard. Thank you. I was concerned there wasn't a redo of the old "I'll buy it for a high price" line, because I love that line because it illustrated what a shitty haggler the merchant is. Came into some other bits and bobs too, mate. Anything else I can help you with? Don't get yourself killed now. Oh, here we go.
Viper hunter,
find the vipers. You specifically have to sell them to the merchant, so you can't eat them like I just did.
Oh.
So I guess we've fucked that one up.
But it would acknowledge, like, if you already had one on you, it would acknowledge that one. It's not like you pick up the quest and then you have to find three more from that point.
Yeah, if you already had one, I could. If I hadn't eaten the one I just found, I could have sold it just now to go towards that quest.
Listen, you had a hunger for the snake. I don't blame you.
I do like to force a big fat snake through me lips.
Through me lips.
Oh, hello.
What was that? What's he doing? Just hanging by coffin?
Just hanging out, so I'll just stab him in the throat.
And his coffin's right there, so easy burial.
Now that's pretty weak in terms of crafting materials. Resources! You found a small resources, which is not quite as good as a medium resources.
What game?
Where's the imagination, people? At least call it like metal parts or something.
I played something recently, where it's just a thing. It's just like a single... I think it's The Last of Us, maybe? You just get... Oh, there's just those like pills in The Last of Us. You collect enough pills, you can like become stronger. Miriam, thank you so much for a £2 dono. What would a female Mortimer be like?
I'm curious. Big whore. Probably one of them femme fatale con artist types.
Ooh. Jack filled in for you on Slate Something Else on Monday, and he was talking about how much planning he's doing for season 3, which will, theory, begin filming on Tuesday.
We've got to, like, do two straight days of D&Ding when we first arrive, so he's got to be prepared for any eventuality.
His worry is that all of his preparations are going to be quickly dashed.
That's almost certainly going to happen, yes.
I see. I can think of one reason they'd want to do so.
Oh, she's here. That's for sure. I'll find a way in.
Last cause. No, I'm definitely not getting confused with the Max Payne things. I have been paying minimal attention to Nick's Max Payne gameplay. And the pill thing was definitely in The Last of Us Part 1, which I played recently. The Ghost of Tsushima just had supplies. That's pretty funny.
Supplies.
Our topic for something else on Monday was our favorite and least favorite video game endings.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have any that have stood out to you? What would you have talked? We brought up Silent Hill. Don't worry, Silent Hill 2.
Oh well, okay then.
In your honor.
I remember really liking the endings for Infamous 2. I was surprised that it had a good ending and a bad ending, and they were both pretty good, which is surprising.
Yeah, that's right. We were talking about games where your choice impacts the ending. Usually, have kind of disappointing endings.
Well, that's
a lot of folks talk about Mass Effect, which we didn't play. So, yeah,
the old ending Tron 3000 problem. Oh boy, a side quest. What's this one? Do you think?
Ooh,
kill 4 rabbits. Oh no, it's Blue Emblems again.
Wow, wonderful.
Oh no, it's not. It's destroy the emblems of the twins. Which I guess is a reference to the puzzle in the original game where you had to use the twin headstones in the Grey Cemetery to figure out what symbols you had to light up on a machine.
That's right.
In this case, we just have to find the grave for some twins and break them, and that's it.
Easy peasy.
Oh, here it is. There we go. Money for old rope.
Okay.
That was literally it. That's all you have to do.
Listen. That was dumb. However, we get spindles, so I'm not going to complain. God knows I love my spindle.
What is a spindle?
I don't know.
Is a spindle a real thing?
Googling it. Spindle. A spindle is a mineral that owes its beautiful color to chromium, much like rubies and emeralds do.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, it's real. Dumb spun.
I wish I could decide when Leon turns his flashlight on.
Oh, it's just auto?
Yeah, he's got one, but he only brings it out in, like, scripted areas in the really, really dark places. Oh, we're heading towards the lake boss fight. I'm not sure if we're going to get to it in time.
No, it's a bit of a ways.
Oh, hello. Come and get me.
Andrew, come on. I have no idea how to pronounce it because I've never heard a human being pronounce it. I just call it spindles.
You just walk straight into the fire, you dumb twat.
I mean, they don't feel pain anymore, right? So they just kind of like, they're like Terminators at this point.
I guess. Really shitty Terminators.
Miriam with another 2 pounds. Thank you so much. I'm drawing a female Mort now. What does she look like? Well, regular Mort with like a sundress.
Sure.
And bangs.
Bangs?
Bangs.
You like bangs?
B- bank, or what are they? What isn't there an Australian term for banks?
You mean a fringe, right?
Fringe, yeah, that's the term.
That's also a British term for it.
Oh, I was very one of those things where Americans are probably wrong.
I was very confused for the longest time by what people meant when they said bangs.
Yeah, I mean, a fringe is probably a better term for it, but I've been using bangs for a long time, so no use changing now. George Lucas said just Mortimer, but in Ada Wong's dress. It's not bad.
With a split seam. I'm into it.
Harry son.
Wow. You are very rude.
Harry son with $5 Australian. Thank you so much. How often have you personally received review codes for AAA games since EP began? Yachts? Any particular ones you remember enjoying the most?
I don't really remember what I was given codes for. A lot.
Several.
What do you mean personally? No one came to my door with an engraved envelope or anything.
Yeah.
They were sent to me personally as an email or something.
Yeah. And also, it's personally, it's like, it's not like the developer wasn't like, I have one code and I will give it to you and only you. IGN had the review up and GameSpot had the review up. And it is, it does make all of our jobs easier to get code nice in advance, to prep content for when stuff goes up.
And I like to say that it's fine the zero punctuation comes out later than other reviews, because it means we can all, you know, have time to digest the game. Mm-hmm. But in reality, if I could get advanced copies for every single game, I would very much prefer that.
Well, because if, in this scenario, if you weren't able to get the game until it comes out tonight, you would not, your review, you won't review it until like the end of April because of the upcoming trip,
so. Well, yeah.
You know, this particular case was very nice. The review came in plenty of time.
Suspiciously so.
Dun, dun, dun. Saboteur.
Well, they gave me an advanced copy so I could piss all over it. So I'm not sure what the long game was.
I mean, the game is reviewing incredibly well, so I think their plan on the grand scheme of things is fine. Finding someone big enough to
use this thing. Oh, it's Blue Medallions again.
Yay!
Hey, who remembers this place?
I do. Get those birds.
Hey, it still works.
Oh, I didn't realize a single flashbang kills all of them?
Yeah. See, incredible. The flash bomb actually does cause damage. It does like 1 point of damage. And birds,
and that's all it needs for the birds.
Birds only have one health point, so it works out well.
Do the flashbangs still instant kill the mutated?
Yes,
monsters?
They do.
Yeah.
And once you know that, it makes the game a lot easier.
Yes. Because those things are a pain in the ass. Especially when there's multiple of them. Ooh. How is the water room? The water hallway?
Largely intact. And still a pain in the ass.
This was one of my favorite rooms in the original game.
The merchant's little grotto.
The little grotto, yeah.
Come on, go. Let's get to that lake boss fight.
So we can shoot the water and see if we die.
Yeah, forget everything else.
Yeah.
Shoot the water, see if we die.
Did we already skip the point, or is it coming up the QTE where you have to run away from the boulder?
Yeah, so all those QTEs are out.
Rest in peace, cuties.
Here it is. Oh, hang on. That's right. We have to find a gas can for the boats. We probably won't get to the boss fight.
Oh yeah,
now.
This is definitely differently. This is designed differently than the original game was.
Hey, incredible. They remembered.
Incredible. I loved that scavenger trick Nick into doing that in VR, and Nick almost shot himself. I think that's great.
Where are we? 253. Oh my.
Jamal, what are your top three Resi games? One remake, two remake, four.
Four, seven. That'll do me, actually.
Another.
Oh, you know what we could do in the last 5 minutes?
Take the elevator. Da, 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 shooting gallery? Da, da,
shooting gallery!
Wonderful.
Except weirdly, instead of characters from the game, the targets are all pirates now.
That's very strange. What? Maybe this is a hint. Maybe the next Resident Evil game is going to have pirates.
Don't shoot the nice pirates.
Comedogenes says, it seems like they toned down the gore in all these remakes, and that's disappointing. It feels pretty gory to me. I don't know, it feels pretty gory to me. Resident Evil 2 remake is gory as all shit.
Oh, buggered that up. Don't patronize me, game.
Yay.
That wasn't worth an A rank.
Yar got an A. It's Japan, so you didn't get an S ranking. So. Rely too much on a single weapon, and you'll find yourself out of ammo, mate.
Let's try the rifle, of course.
Ooh. There's a little man hiding out in his little barrel.
Oh.
Last Cost says, even though we're not playing Sea of Thieves, we still get a little pirate Thursday on The Escapist. See? There you go.
Hey.
Oh, that cheeky, one went so fast.
Cheeky fast pirate.
So what's your prizes for these?
Well, we get fun bucks, but there are different kind of fun bucks.
Oh,
the fun bucks that you put in this machine. And then you get shit.
Gachapon.
Hey, I got soldier with hammer.
So those are the little danglies. Wonderful.
Lovely. Let's customize our danglies.
Incredible.
As we used to say in the locker room after sports. Yeah, you're not using your own ammo in the shooting gallery, players, if you were concerned about that. You get free ammo and fully upgraded guns. What was I going to do? Oh, yeah.
Upgrade your danglies. Danglies. Danglies.
We can have up to three danglies. And they
they give you actually little buffs.
They convey little perks.
Well, that's nice.
But you could easily get by without it, so I didn't really...
Yeah.
I didn't really bother much with the shooting game.
And I like you don't have to micromanage them. You're not constantly getting new items, like... This is a weird gear race. I appreciate this.
Plus 20% handgun ammo craft bonus frequency. Oh, I think when you're crafting ammo, sometimes on a random roll, you get like an extra bullet or two.
Okay. Does it still do the thing where if you upgrade the capacity of a gun, you automatically refill its ammo?
No, actually. I acted on the assumption that it did, and it doesn't.
Yeah, that helped me out of many a pickle in my recent playthrough.
It's annoying because it means the broken butterfly doesn't have much ammo.
Yeah.
Actually use. Scavenger gives $5, says, I assume the halter top and hip huggers for Ashley are gone. Is the suit of armor still around? Well, she does still have, like, the short skirt, but, and I did check this out, she doesn't scold you for trying to look up it. In fact, I think when I examined it more closely during gameplay, it seems to be a pair of booty shorts cunningly disguised as a miniskirt.
Incredible. When I examined it closely, when I did my research, like a real games critic, like a backroom horde dog.
So here's all the challenges that you use to unlock, like bonus points that you use to unlock the bonuses. Defeat 5 enemies with bolt thrower. Yeah, I wasn't going to do that. And hey, this is what I was talking about in my review. All the achievements for killing a boss are references to the fun dialogue from the camp version of the game.
Oh.
See, defeating Ramon Salazar, it's called No Thanks, Bro.
So it's one of those things where it's like, you remember what the fun dialogue is, you chose not to use it.
Exactly. Complete all challenges. Booger that. Complete the main story without talking to the merchant once.
That's insane.
Bugger
also,
off
that would
with that
be so
too.
Rude. You would just walk by him a bunch.
Complete the main story using only knives and handguns.
Crazy people. Absolute crazy people.
Complete the main story without using a recovery item.
Nope.
Nuts.
Not in this economy. Not in this economy.
Nuts, nuts, nuts. Yeah, this is how you get the Chicago typewriter, which is now called the Chicago Sweeper. Complete the main story on professional mode with an A rank.
Why did they change that?
I don't know. But you can also unlock a gas mask to wear. Or a chicken hat.
You go like a TV's hunk?
Sure. And if you complete hardcore mode with an S rank, you get a chicken hat.
Just like Metal Gear Solid 5.
And here's how you get the suit of armor for Ashley that we all wanted. Complete the main story on hardcore with an A rank.
No, I'm going to be honest, I'm not going to do that.
Ooh, we can get antlers. Complete the main story on standard mode with an S rank, and we can wear antlers.
I like that.
Yeah, I only got Promising Agents, I'm afraid.
I think you did great.
Tell you what, let's go back to the main menu and look at all the unlockables that I haven't bought. This will be worth the super chat.
There you go.
Okay. So, a lot of stuff you need to complete the challenges to unlock, but we can equip Leon with his jacket for default, or his non-jacket mode from like start to finish. Or we could have the sunglasses, or a face guard, or a spooky skull mask.
Wow.
I like that.
I like his like little winter hat. That winter hat.
We could probably put that on right now. So if we just reload a save.
We're gonna be winter Leon.
I guess it will probably have to replace the fedora.
Can't be a two-hat guy.
Yes.
Hell yeah.
There's nothing about this that does not work.
Goofy as shit. That's great.
All right. Well, on that note, thanks to you everyone for watching the post-CP stream. If you're interested in my review of the Resident Evil 4 remake, you can go to escapismagazine.com and watch it right now, functioning video player permitting. If not, you can either watch it on YouTube in a week's time, or you can watch it on YouTube now if you're a YouTube member or Patreon subscriber. Remembered in the end. Sorry, I've had a long week.
It's been a while. You haven't streamed in 7 whole days.
I know.
8 whole days. It was last Wednesday. Oh, my gosh.
Crazy, right? Well, on Monday, I'm off to Milwaukee, so you won't be seeing me for a while.
Yeah. Although we'll be doing, I think we're planning to do a game night.
Oh, yes. Airbnb, an in-person game night stream at some point.
So timing. TBD.
We'll see you then. In the meantime, you can watch Extra Punctuation on YouTube. That went out today. Or there will be some other stuff. What other stuff is out this week?
Tune back in 2 hours from now. Casey and I will be back finishing Half-Life or dying, trying, and then probably starting up a little bit of Black Mesa tomorrow. Like I said, at noon, tune in. Frost and I will be playing through Dredge, which is a game both of us very much enjoy. And then, we'll have Wishlist and Game Night on Saturday. We don't know what yet, but we'll have that. And otherwise, check out the website. A lot of great content. I put up an op-ed on the newly announced Persona 5 weird mobile sequel only in China that looks incredible, but will undoubtedly disappoint with its gacha mechanics.
Yeah, I'm surprised it took this long for that to come up with us two being on the stream.
For them to milk that, yeah. That trailer looks so good. And also, instead of Morgana, it's an owl, which I'm a big fan of.
Yeah, it just seems like Persona 5, but all the characters are different individuals.
Yeah, it's very strange. Tune in for that. Otherwise, I'll see you guys in 2 hours for more Half-Life.
All right, then. And it just remains for me to pick up my bloody keyboard again. And bring up my sleepy dog.
Sleeping dogs.
Sleepy. Dog. Woof. Want a furry hat. Goodbye, everyone.
Bye, everybody.